Today, I'm in Mooresville, North Carolina with Billy from Billy Boat Exhaust. Billy, I've got a problem that I'm working on my 1969 Trans Am with the exhaust system. I'm trying to design for it. I really need some expert advice, so I came to you. Tell us a little bit about your business.
I started Billy Boat Exhaust in the early 90s. I learned to weld when I was 8 years old, built my first set of headers when I was 12, so in my dad's garage. So, you know, we've got a lot of history in the exhaust business, so I think we might have just what we need to help you out. You know, we build exhaust systems and mufflers for a variety of performance and racing cars, so, you know, we do have the experience and the knowledge and the quality that I think we're going to be able to do what you need to do.
Outstanding. So, and you're not just famous for your exhaust, right? I mean, you've been in the motorsports industry for a long time.
Yeah, I've been racing for a long time, had a great career in the USAC midgets, and with IndyCar, I ran 70 Indianapolis 500. So I think racing and the quality and engineering that it takes in the racing business definitely translates over to our general exhaust business. Mm-hmm. I think that's what's helped to make us as successful as we've been.
Oh, for sure, yeah. With muffler design, that's out of my league, you know? Yeah, and so I want to be able to come into the muffler from the front and actually exit out the side. And I've not seen something like that really on the market. On my Chevelle, I go in on the front and out in the front, and then I turn it out the side. With the smaller wheelbase of the 69 Trans Am, it's not feasible. So that's my challenge.
For your design, yep. What we're gonna do, it's gonna be unique because we're gonna start with these end plates. Now we actually buy this blank, we have a die that we stamp these, so we form this edge. This edge helps to create strength in the muffler.
Okay.
And you said you wanted your muffler 14 inches long.
Yes.
You want a side inlet or an end inlet offset, yep. Like that.
Yes.
But we want it to come out the side.
Yeah, off the same front. So,
right, so it's going to come out.
Yeah, so if this is the inlet, it's actually going to come out here.
Right.
So somehow you got to run it down this way and make it do a U-turn and come back out this way.
You know what, and what's unique about this muffler, it's almost the exact same muffler I built to run on a sprint car at Paris Speedway in the 2000s.
No way.
So we had a muffler rule at Paris when we were racing out there when I was racing with Chad, and we designed a muffler that met the noise rule for Paris. Almost going to be exactly what we're doing for you. So
really?
I definitely have some experience in this area.
Oh, this is great. Yeah, yeah.
We also, you know, we're going to build, so we developed this because you do need the oval design, which is different than our standard round, right?
Yep.
We've made a pattern here. We're going to cut the oval shape in the plasma more like this. So this will be the inlet side of our muffler.
Okay.
We'll use this style of end plate on the inlet. We're going to have an inner end plate that's going to support the tube. And then we're going to have an outlet.
Oh.
So it's going to be three pieces, tube in between it, and then we're going to build a box at the end. So we're going to turn it.
Okay.
So that it does a 180.
Yeah.
And then we'll get our outlet.
Okay.
We can get started making some of these pieces.
Yeah.
So Andy, one of the key pieces of equipment we use in developing and forming our mufflers is this Weld Logic CNC roller, and what this allows us to do is not only roll just round tubes, various arcs, but also different shapes. So we can actually roll the entire case of a muffler, of an oval muffler, just all in one roll. Inside of the muffler, we're going to use two of these perforated tubes, 3 inch in diameter. We have this perforated manufactured, and then we cut it to various sizes.
Okay.
And what we'll do is we're gonna roll it, and then we're gonna spot weld the seam, and then we'll come back and we'll probably have to, because yours is an oval design, yeah. We'll probably have to come back and shape it a little bit to your end plate, but it should get us what we need.
I see.
This is all 304 domestically sourced stainless steel.
Okay.
So, you know, that's the only stainless that we use in our mufflers. What we'll do now is we're going to form the actual skin for the outside of the muffler. Said you wanted your muffler 14 inches long.
Okay.
Now we'll form the oval shell that we're going to put around it.
Okay.
Because of the kind of unique configuration of your muffler, instead of forming the muffler and then putting a seam on it and going over the top, we're going to form it and then come around it like a clamshell because we're going to have to trim around the outlet because you want it to come out the side.
Yeah.
A little more challenging, but we can do it.
Okay.
All right. Because of the unique configuration of we're gonna come out the side on your system, right?
Yeah.
So we're gonna put this piece of solid stainless over the top of this so that when we put the outlet on, it gives us a nice solid surface to weld to.
Okay.
So what we'll do now is we're gonna spot weld this on.
Yeah.
We'll come back, we'll cut an oval hole in it.
Oh, okay.
And then we'll fit your oval tube to this piece and it'll come out the side.
I see. Okay. Yep.
Rather than just allowing this to go into a chamber, I like to keep this inside. So we'll build this box at the end. So that'll kind of help keep the velocity up,
okay.
Help it turn the corner and keep it rotated right into the other tube.
Okay.
Otherwise, if you just go into blow into an open chamber here, sometimes you create some turbulence and you don't get quite as good a flow.
Warning. Read and follow all labels and your owner's manuals.
Now that we've got our 180 box tacked together, we're going to weld it to our inner end plate, which will create the section that'll make the 180 turn for the muffler. We would normally stitch this box to the end plate. We wouldn't fully weld it just to try to keep some of the heat out of the end plate, and there's really no reason to have the box fully welded inside the muffler itself. The stainless mesh, again, is our base layer material. And that's what we use just right around the muffler core itself. Then I'll cut that off. And then we'll go with the fiberglass mat material. We use the twine material just to wrap the muffler, wrap around the two packing materials just to hold it tight as we pack it together. Now that we've got the muffler core wrapped, we'll put the muffler skin on it. We've already fitted around the outlet. Now we'll use a series of clamps and hand technique to final assemble it.
Okay, and you're using the Dynasty, what are these all, Dynasty 210s?
Dynasty 210s is what the majority of my machines are, yes.
Excellent, sweet. Masterpiece.
You know, this custom piece for you should sound great on your project.
Oh, there's no doubt. Excellent. Well, thank you so much for your time and your engineering expertise.
I appreciate working with you guys.
My plan was to use the original pocket to mount these custom Billy Boat mufflers. But I really need to make an adjustment. They need to be moved forward about 4 inches. And that's because I decided to use these heavy-duty four-link mounts from Detroit Speed instead of just using the stock leaf spring mount or making my own. These are definitely the easy button. But they have an additional mounting hole, which lowers the total length of the mount by another 1.25 inches. Which puts it right in the way of my outlet port. So my options are either lower the muffler, which I don't want to do, or just slide it a little bit forward. I'm already cutting some of this foot pan out anyway for clearance for the inlet tube, so all I'm really going to do is just make the back part a little bit wider to accommodate the muffler. I'm zipping this thing out with the Spectrum 375 plasma cutter set for 17 amps, and I'm plugged in to 120 volt input power. Something like that. On second thought, I decided to remove the whole foot pan area. It'll be easier for me to make a replacement piece and it'll look better. Now with oval tubing, it's a little trickier to work with because you can't clock the tubing to make it fit better. I found if I mount my X-pipe and my muffler solid to the car with some temporary tubing, it'll be easier for me to make those small cuts and adjustments so I can get it just right. And fitting these in place with some small drop-off tubes I pulled out of my scrap pile and tacking them with the Multimatic 220 set for 16 gauge. Okay, now the not so fun stuff. A lot of measuring, cutting, grinding, fitting, and repeating. I like to use tape. That way it makes sure that I cut my line straight. Okay, here's a quick tip for you. To make your grinding a little quicker,
clamp a straight edge along the bottom and then another one along the side so you can fit your piece up in here. And that way you'll be able to hit both your points and you can tell where you need to do some finish grinding. So on this one I can see that I got a little space on this side, but this side is tight. And then once I grind this to fit, then I'll be able to measure the space here and cut my final piece to fit in there. That's money. Clamp that down and tack it into place. This is 304 stainless and I'm using 308L filler metal. Okay, now let's just measure my gap for my extension piece. Looks like 5 1/16. 5 1/16. 5 1/16. This is looking good. 5. All right, so I got a little bit of grinding to do. 5 1/16 it is. That's perfect. All right, the next three verses are the same as the first, so you don't need to stick around for that. Next time on Real Garage, we're knocking out the spider bars.